I have sailed the world, beheld its wonders, from the Dardanelles to the mountains of Peru. But there's no place like London. I feel home again. I can hear the city bells ring, whatever I would do. No, there's no place like London.
Mr. Todd, sir.
You are young. Life has been kind to you. You will learn. It is here we go our several ways.
Farewell, Anthony. I will not soon forget the good ship Bountiful, or the young man who saved my life.
Must you glare at me, woman? Off with you. Off, I say!
Then how'd you like to split me muff, Mr. Wiggle Jig Jig, little bouncer out the
room? Off, I say! To the devil with you!
There's somewhere I must go. Something I must find out now. And alone.
But surely, Mr. Todd, we'll meet again, before I'm off to Plymouth?
If you want, you well may find me around Fleet Street. I shouldn't wonder.
Well, until then, Mr. Todd.
There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and it's filled with people who are filled with shit. The vermin of the world inhabit.
A woman alone with limited wings.
Ah, sir, times is hard. Times is hard!
Isn't that a room up there over the shop? If times are so hard, why don't you rent it out?
Up there? Well, no one will go near it. People think it's haunted. You see, years ago, something happened up there. Something not very nice. There was a barber and his wife, and he was beautiful. A proper artist with a knife, but they transported him for life, and he was beautiful. Barker was his name. Benjamin Barker.
Transported, you say? What was his crime?
Foolishness. He had this wife, you see. Pretty little thing, silly little nit, had her chance for the world on a string. Poor thing, poor thing. There were these two, you see. Wanted her like mad. One of them a judge, other one is Beedle. Every day they'd nudge and they'd wheedle. Still she wouldn't budge from her needle. Too bad, poor thing. So they merely shipped the poor blighter all south they did, leaving her with nothing but grief and a year-old kid. Did she use her head even then? Oh no, God forbid. Poor fool. Oh, but there was worse yet to come. Poor thing. Joanna, that was the baby's name. Pretty little Joanna.
Go on.
Oh my, you do like a good story, don't you? Well, Beedle calls on her all polite. Poor thing, poor thing. The judge, he tells her, is all contrite. He blames himself for her dreadful plight. She must go straight to his house tonight. Poor thing, poor thing. Of course, when she gets there, poor dear, poor thing, they're having this ball all in masks. There's no one she knows there, poor dear, poor thing. She wanders tormented and drinks, poor thing. The judge has repented, she thinks, poor thing. Oh, where is Judge Turpin, she asked. He was there all right, only not so contrite. She wasn't no match for such craft, you see, and everyone thought it so droll. They figured she had to be daft, you see, so all of them stood there and laughed, you see. Poor soul, poor thing.
Would no one have mercy on her?
So it is you, Benjamin Barker.
Not Barker. Not Barker. Todd now. Sweeney Todd. Where is she? Where is my wife? Where's Lucy?
She poisoned herself. I tried to stop her, but she wouldn't listen to me.
And my daughter?
He's got her.
Judge Turpin.
Even he had a conscience tucked away, I suppose. Adopted her like his own. You could say it was good luck for her. Almost.
15 years. Sweating in a living hell. On a trumped up charge. 15 years. Dreaming that I might come home to a loving wife and child. Let them quake in their boots. Judge Turpin and the Beadle. For their hour has come.
Have you got any money? Listen to me! Have you got any money?
No.
Well, then how are you going to live, even?
I'll live. If I have to sweat in the sewers or in the plague hospital, I'll live. And I will have them.
Oh, you poor thing. You poor thing. Wait. When they came for the little girl, I hid him away. You can be a barber again. My. Them handles is chase silver, ain't they?
Silver, yes. These are my friends. See how they glisten. See this one shine. How he smiles in the light. My friend, my faithful friend. Speak to me, friend. Whisper, I'll listen. I know, you've been locked out of sight all these years, like me, my friend. Well, I've come home to find you waiting. We're together, and we'll do wonders, won't we? You there, my friend.
I'm your friend too, Mr. Todd.
Come, let me hold you.
If you only knew. Mr. Todd,
you grow warm in my hand, my friend.
You've come home,
my clever friend.
Always have fondness for your
mother. Rest now, my friend.
Never you.
Soon
I'll
hold you.
You can move in
soon,
Mr.
You
Todd.
Know wonders you never have dreamed all your years. Rubies. My right arm is complete again.
Teach me how to sing, if I can.
have sailed the world, beheld its wonders, from the pearls of Spain to the rubies of Tibet, but not even in London have I seen such a wonder.
Is this?
That's the great Judge Turpin's house.
And the young woman who resides there.
Oh, that's a pretty little ward, Joanna. But don't go trespassing there. Not if you value your hide.
I feel Joanna. I was half convinced I'd waken, satisfied enough to dream you. Happily, I was mistaken. Joanna, I'll steal you. Joanna, I'll steal you.
Joanna!
Oh, dear.
I see you here, on this or any neighbor's street. You'll rue the day you were born. Is that plain enough to speak for you?
I feel you, Joanna. And one day I'll steal you. Till I'm with you, then I'm with you then. Sweetly buried in your yellow
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Do you wake every morning in shame and despair to discover your pillow is covered in hair? What not ought to be there? Well, ladies and gentlemen, from now on you can waken with ease. You need never again have worry or care. I will show you a miracle marvelous rare. Gentlemen, you are about to see something what rose from the dead. On the top of my head. T'was Pirelli's miracle elixir. That's what did the trick, sir. True, sir, true. Was it quick, sir? Did it in a tick, sir? Just like an elixir ought to do. How about a bottle, missus?
What is this?
What is this? Tell me about the bottle. Have you ever smelled a cleaner smell? How about a sample,
piss.
Mister?
Wouldn't touch it if I was
how
you.
How about a sample?
Piss with me.
Let me smell that bottle. I don't want to drink.
What does this say?
Never mind the madman. Never mind the madman, mister.
Where's his Pirelli?
Yeah, where's his Pirelli? Pirelli's activate the roots, sir.
Keep it off your boots, sir. Eats right through.
Get Pirelli's. Buy a bottle of it. Ladies seem to love it.
Flies to two.
Oh, Pirelli, the king of the bar of kings of Buongiorno, good day.
I blow you a kiss. And I, the so famous Pirelli, I wish to know who has the nerve to say my elixir is pierced.
Who says it is?
I do. My name is Sweeney Todd, and I have opened a bottle of Pirelli's elixir and say to you, sir, it is nothing but an arrant fraud, and furthermore, I have service, no kings, yet I'll wager I can shave a cheek with 10 times more dexterity than any street mountebank. You see these razors?
I wager them against £5. You are no match for me.
These are indeed fine erasers. Instruments are like as these, or once seen, cannot to be soon forgotten. You wager these against the £5.
Will Beetle Bamford be the judge? Happy as always to oblige my friends and neighbors.
All right, you, sir.
How about a shave?
Ready?
Ready.
Ready?
Ready!
The fastest, smoothest shave is the winner.
Now, signorini, signora, we mix the lather, but first you gather round. Signorini, signori, you look at a man who having a glory to shave the Pope. Mr. Sweeney, whoever, I beg your pardon, will probably say it was only a cardinal. It was the Pope to shave the face, to pull the tout, required the grace, and not to the brute. For if you slip your neck at the skin, you clip at the chin, you rip the lip of it, and that's the truth. To shave the face, or even a part, without the smart, require the heart. To take the heart, I show you a chart. I study starting in my youth. To shave the face, to trim the beard, to make the bristle clean like a whistle, it is from any infancy the talent here to read. By God! It take the skill, it take the brains, it take the will, to take the pains, it take the grace, I win a race.
The winner is Todd. I bow to a skill far defter than my own. Come, boy. Excuse me, Mr. Todd, sir. Do you have an establishment of your own?
He certainly does. Sweeney Todd's Tonsorial Parlor above my meat pie shop on Fleet Street.
Then you will surely see me there before the week is out.
Why doesn't the beadle come? Before the week is out. That's what he said.
And who says the week is out? It's only Friday. Easy now. Hush, love, hush. Don't distress yourself, what's your rush? Keep your thoughts nice and lush. Wait. Don't you know, silly man, half the fun is to plan the plan. All good things come to those who flowers, maybe, instead of daisies, I don't know though. What do you think? Gillyflowers, I'd say. Nothing like a nice bowl of gillies.
Mr. Todd, I have found the most beautiful and loving maid any man could dream of, and yet she has a guardian so tyrannical that she is kept shuttered from the human eye. Until this morning, when a key fell from her very window, the surest sign that Joanna loves me.
Joanna?
Yes, ma'am, that's her name. And Turpin, that of the abominable parent, a judge, it seems. When he leaves for court, I'll slip into the house and plead with her to fly with me tonight. Yet when I have her,
the girl may come.
A thousand blessings on you both.
You'll have her back before the day is out.
Until he carries her off to the other end of England.
Well, let him bring her here, and then since you're so hot for a little...
Buongiorno, Mr. Todd. Oh, bellissima signorina.
Oh, how do you do, signor, I'm sure?
A moment for a little business with a Mr. Todd.
Oh, not a problem. I'll just pop on down to me pies.
Mr. Todd.
Signor Pirelli.
Call me Danny. Danny O'Higgins is the name. When it's not professional.
It's not much, but I imagine you're pretty up a bit.
I'd like my £5 back, if you don't mind.
Why?
Well, it should hold me over till your customers start coming. Well, then it's half your profits you give me each week on a Friday. Share and share alike. Isn't that right, Mr. Benjamin Barker?
Why do you call me that?
You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just a down-and-out Irish lad you hired for a couple of weeks, sweeping up hair and such like. But I remember these. And you, Benjamin Barker, later transported to Botany Bay for life.
So, Mr. Todd, do we have a deal, or do I have to run down the street to my good pal, Beetle Bamford?
You think you smart, you foolish boy! Tomorrow you start in my employ, you understand? You like my plan?
Walk home with me, for I have news for you. In order to shield Joanna from the evils of this world, I have decided to marry her next Monday.
Ah, sir, happy news indeed.
But strange, when I offered myself to her, she showed a certain reluctance.
Ladies in their sensitivities, my lord, have a fragile sensibility. When a girl's emergent, probably it's urgent you defer to her gentility, my lord. Personal disorder cannot be ignored, given their genteel proclivities. Meaning no offense, it happens they resent it. Ladies in their sensitivities, my lord.
Stubble, you say?
Fret not though, my lord, I know a place, my lord, a barber, my lord of skill. Thus armed with a shaven face, my lord, some eau de cologne to brace, my lord, and musk to enhance the chase, my lord, you'll dazzle the girl until. She bows to your every will.
Take me to him.
These premises are hardly prepossessing. And yet the beadle tells me that you are the most accomplished of all the barbers in the city.
And what may I do for you, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair. A soothing skin massage.
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and pumice stone, and lend me a more seductive tone. A sprinkling, perhaps, of French cologne. But first, sir, I think, shave.
The closest I ever gave.
You're in a merry mood today, Mr. Todd.
'Tis your delight, sir, catching fire from one man to the next.
'Tis true, sir, love can still inspire the blood to pound, the heartly pyre. What more can man require than love, sir?
More than love, sir?
What's that?
Women.
Ah, yes, women.
Pretty women. Mm-hmm.
and if we wed, you'll be commended, sir.
My lord, and who may it be said is your intended, sir?
My ward, and as pretty as a rosebud.
As pretty as her mother!
What was that?
Nothing, sir. Nothing! May we proceed.
Pretty women, fascinating, sipping coffee, dancing pretty women are a wonder. Pretty women, sitting in the window or standing on the something in them cheers the air. Pretty women, silhouetted, stay within you, glancing, stay forever,
breathing lightly.
Pretty women,
pretty women.
Their garden,
her writing,
our picking,
the watching,
how they make
romancing forever, as you're living.
Pretty women,
sir,
pretty women,
yes, pretty women, sir, pretty women, sir, pretty women.
Joanna marries me Sunday, everything said, we leave tonight.
Joanna! With you, I'll lock her away in some obscure retreat where neither you nor any other vile, corrupting youth will ever lay eyes on her again. And as for you, Barbara, it is all too clear the company you keep. Service them well and hold their custom, for you will have none of mine.
Mr. Todd?
Out! Out, I say! All this running and shouting, what is it now, dear?
I had him.
And then? The sailor busted in. I saw them both running down the street, and I said to myself, well, the facts and the fire
now. I had him.
His throat was there beneath my hand.
Oh, there, dear. Don't fret.
No, I had him. His throat was there, and he'll never come again.
Is he now? Hush, love, hush. I keep telling you. What's
when?
Your rush?
Why did I wait?
You told me to wait.
Now he'll never come again. There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and it's filled with people who are filled with shit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it.
Tell you why. Because in all of the whole human race, Mrs. Lovett, there are two kinds of men and only two. There's the one staying put in the proper place, and the one with his foot in the other one's face. Look at me, Mrs. Lovett, look at you.
We all deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. Because the lives of the wicked should be made brief. For the rest of us, death will be a relief. They all deserve to die. No, not one man, no, not 10 men, nor 100 can assuage me. I will have you.
And I will get him back, even as he gloats. In the meantime, I'll practice on less honorable throats. And my Lucy lies in ashes, and I'll never hold my girl to me. But the work waits. I'm alive and
at last, and I'm full.
Well, that's all well and good. But what about the Italian?
Later on, when it's dark, we'll take him some secret place and bury him.
Well, of course we can do that. I don't suppose he has any family that's gonna come poking around looking for him. But you know me. Ideas just pop into me head. Seems a downright shame.
Shame.
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame. What's his name has? Had. Has. Nor it can't be traced. Business needs a lift. Debts to be erased. Think of it as thrift, as a gift. If you get my drift. Seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it.
Yeah.
Good you got it. Take for instance Mrs. Mooney and her pie shop. Business never better using only pussycats and toast. And a pussy's good for 6 or maybe 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Lovett, what a charming notion,
well,
eminently practical and yet appropriate as always. Mrs. Lovett,
it's
how I lived without you all these years, I'll never know.
Think
how
about
delectable.
It. What about the gentlemen who should be coming in for shames? Won't they think
how
choice, all those
how rare.
Pies?
For what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd? What, Mr. Todd? What is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air. It's man devouring man, my dear. And who are we to deny it in here?
What's this?
It's priest. Have a little priest.
Is it any good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Though, of course, they don't commit sins of the flesh. So it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
No, you see, the trouble with poet is how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Have charity towards the world, my pet.
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High born and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. No, we'll serve anyone,
meaning anyone, and to anyone at all.
Thank you.
I think I miss you less and less as every day goes by. Joanna,
with you we sang me on a Sunday,
and married on a Sunday, and pale and look too much like her. If only angels could prevail, we'd be the way we were. Joanna,
I'll steal you
on a Sunday. Do you hear me, Mr. T?
Of course.
Well, then what did I say then?
There must be a way to the judge.
Oh, the bloody judge. We got a nice, respectable business here, money coming in regular and whatnot, and since we're careful to pick and choose only those what won't be missed, well, who could catch on? Oh, Mr. Todd, I'm so happy. I could eat you up, I really could. You know what I'd like to do, Mr. Todd? What a dream. If the business stays as good, where I'd really like to go in a year or so. Don't you want to know?
Of course.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, yes, I do, I do.
By the...
Mr. Todd! Mr. Todd! I found her.
You found Joanna? Where?
That monster of a judge had her locked away in a madhouse.
A madhouse?
Joanna is as good as saved.
She is.
Where do you think the wig makers of London go to obtain their human hair? They get it from the lunatics at Bedlam. I need to turn you into a credible wig maker. And fast. Go now, wait for me upstairs.
I put the sold-out sign up, Mum.
That's my boy. Look, dear. A lovely muffler. And guess who it's for?
Coo. For me?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Mum, you're too good to me. You know, I think about my time with Signor Pirelli. It's like the good Lord sent you for me.
That's just my warm heart, dear. Room enough there for all God's creatures.
You know, Mum, there's nothing that I wouldn't do for you. If there was a monster or an ogre or anything like that what was after you, I'd rip it apart with my bare fists, I would.
What a sweet child it is.
Or even if it was just a man.
A man, dear.
A man. What was bad and what was luring you, all unbeknownst like unto his evil deeds and whatnot.
What is this? What are you talking about?
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, no sir, not while I'm around. Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays. I'll send them howling, I don't care, I got ways. No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare. Others may desert you, not to worry,
whistle, I'll be there. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing's gonna harm you. Not while I'm around.
You know, dear, it's the strangest thing, you coming to talk to me right now. I'm just sitting here with my needles thinking what a hard-working, obedient boy Toby is. And I was thinking, you know how he always fancy going down to the bakehouse with me to help me make the pies? No time like the present.
Cool. Quite a stink, ain't there?
Always a couple rats gone home to Jesus. Now here is the grinder. And you know the secret, what makes our meat pie so sweet and tender? Three times.
Three times.
You must put the meat through the grinder three times. Smoothly, smoothly.
Two.
That's
three.
My boy.
Cool! Look at me making meat pies on my own. Where are you going, Mum?
Back in a moment, dear.
Smoothly.
Smoothly.
Sweet Polly Plunkett lay in the grass, turn her eyes heavenward sighing. I am a lass who a lass loves a lad, who a lass loves a lass in Canterbury. Tis a row dow diddle dow day, tis a row dow diddle dow dee.
Oh, Beetle Banford! I didn't know you were a music lover, too!
Fine instrument you've acquired.
Oh, yes! It's my pride and joy.
Yes, well, ma'am, I hope you have a few moments, for I'm here today on official business.
Official?
That's it, ma'am. You see, there's been complaints.
Complaints?
About the stink from your chimney. They say at night it's something foul. Health regulations being my duty, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to let me take a look.
At the bakehouse?
Yes, that's right, ma'am.
But it's locked, and I don't have the key. It's Mr. Todd, he has the key, and he's not here right now.
When will he be back?
I couldn't say, I'm sure.
Well, then we'll have to wait for Mr. Todd, won't we? Since you're a fellow music lover, ma'am, why don't you raise your voice along with mine?
Oh, Mr. T! Back already? Look who's here on some official complaint about the bakehouse or something. He wants the key, and I told him you have it. There's no hurry, is there, sir? Why don't you go upstairs with Mr. Todd, and he'll fix you up all nice and pretty. There'll be plenty of time for the bakehouse later.
Well, tell me, Mr. Todd, do you pomade the hair? I dearly love a pomaded head.
I am, sir, entirely at your disposal.
Well, I take that very kindly.
Most honorable Judge Turby.
Most honorable, honorable.
I venture thus to write you this urgent note to warn you that the hot-blooded young sailor has abducted your Joanna. Joanna.
Joanna.
From the institution where you so wisely
could find her.
But hoping to earn your favor, I have persuaded the boy to lodge her here tonight at my tonsorial parlor in Fleet Street. If you want her again in your arms, hurry after the nightfall. She will be waiting,
waiting.
Your obedient, humble servant,
Sweeney Todd.
You, what are you doing here?
Evil is here, sir. The stink of evil. From below. From her.
Out of here, woman.
She's the devil's wife, sir. Beware her, sir. Beware her with no pity in her heart.
Out, I say.
Mr. Todd?
Hey.
Judge.
Don't I know you, Mr.
I have no time. Where is she? Where is the girl?
Below, Your Honor, in the care of my neighbor, Mrs. Lovett. Thank heavens the sailor did not molest her. Thank heavens, too, she has seen the error of her ways.
She has?
Oh, yes. Your lesson was well learned, sir. She speaks only of you, longing for your forgiveness.
And she shall have it. She'll be here soon, you say.
I think I hear her now. Yes. Is that her dainty footstep on the stair?
I hear nothing.
Yes. Isn't that her shadow on the wall?
Where?
There. Primping. Making herself even prettier.
Even prettier.
Oh,
impossible. Pretty women. Quickly, sir. A splash of bay rum.
Joanna.
Pretty women, pretty women are a wonder. Pretty women, yes sir, pretty women, blowing out their candles or combing out their hair. Even when
with fellow tastes, in women at least.
What? What's that?
No doubt the years have changed me. But perhaps the face of a barber, the face of a prisoner in the dock is not particularly memorable.
Benjamin Barker?
Benjamin Barker!
I'll take care of them. Open the doors.
No!
What's the matter with you? It's only some metal.
No, don't touch her!
From the moment I walked into your shop.
You knew my Lucy name.
I was only thinking of you. You're Lucy. A crazy hag picking bones and spuds out of alley ash cans. Would you want me to know that was all that was left of her?
You lied to me.
No, no, not lied at all. No, I never lied. Said she took the poison, she did. Never said that she died. Poor thing, she lived, but it left a week in the head. All she did for months was just lie there in bed. Should have been in hospital, wound up in dead vomit instead. Poor thing, better you should think she was dead. Yes, I lied.
Eminently practical and yet appropriate as always. As you've said repeatedly, there's little point in dwelling on the past.
Do
so
you mean
come
it?
Here,
everything I did, I swear, I thought was only
not
for the best.
Fear,
believe me,
love.
Can
what's
we
dead
still
be is dead.
Married?
The history of the world, my pet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, leave it to me.
Is learn forgiveness and try to forget.
By the sea, Mr. Todd, will be comfy cozy. By the sea, Mr. Todd, there'll be no one nosy.
And life is for the alive, my dear. So let's keep living it, really living it. Just keep living it.
Was a barber and his wife, and she was beautiful. A foolish barber and his wife, she was his reason and his life, and she was beautiful. She was virtuous, and he was.
This man, bake me a cake. No, bake me a pie to delight my eye, and I will sigh if the crust is high. Mr. Todd, it's the old woman. You harmed her too, have you? You shouldn't harm people, Mr. Todd. Watch me grind my corn. Pat him. And prick him. And mark him with a B. And put him in the oven for baby and me! Sweeney Todd. His skin was pale and his eye was hard.
He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again. He trod a path that few have trod, did Sweeney Todd. The demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town. Fancy clients in good renown.
And what if none of their souls were saved? They went to their maker impeccably shaved.
By Sweeney! By Sweeney Todd! The demon barber of Fleet Street!
Hold it to the skies, bring it through.
and the tale of Sweeney Todd.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
To seek revenge may lead to hell.
But everyone does it as seldom as well.
As Sweeney. As Sweeney Todd. The demon barber of Fleet Street.